Hello, I'm Keith Hilson with the Schmidt Music Trombone Shop, back with another mouthpiece review for you. And today I've got a mouthpiece I've been excitedly waiting to share with you. Specifically, one of the brand new mouthpieces from Long Island Brass Company. So this is a project we've been working on for a little while with Jeff Gittleson, the owner, founder, and maker of the Long Island Brass mouthpieces, who of course he's made a real name for himself over the past handful of years between all of his customization work and all of the really innovative mouthpiece stuff he started doing and some really awesome artist collaborations. So we've been working with Long Island Brass to bring some of their mouthpieces in. We've got them in, really excited to share them. And so today I want to start off with one of their artist signature mouthpieces, specifically the Sasha Romero 550 SR. So again, they've had the opportunity to work with Sasha Romero, one of the great players in the Metropolitan Opera. And so really excited to share this with you. I'm going to take this and actually compare it against my trusty Bach 5G. I'm going to be playing all of this on one of our Lake City TR-415 second generation trombones. So I'm going to take a play, take a listen, and we'll talk about it afterward. Thank you. Long Island Brass Company and its founder, Jeff Gittleson, has certainly been on my radar for the past few years. As somebody who has done a really great job on social media, but has really garnered a lot of attention for a lot of the customization work that he's been doing on instruments, a lot of really interesting ideas. The first one that really caught my attention was his baritone trombone, bass trombone, a little bit more compact for flight purposes. I'm still really interested in that. But over the pandemic, Long Island Brass shifted over to mouthpieces. And I think they've been doing some really, really innovative ideas. Not only are they very striking visually, but in terms of their playing and the response, I think there are some fantastic things going on. And obviously, we and many others out there are not the only ones, because they have had already established a couple of really great artist lines, specifically with Sasha Romero and Nick Schwartz, both on the East Coast, fantastic players in their own right. And so when we were talking with Jeff, when we're figuring out, okay, what mouthpieces do we want to carry, one of the ones that really caught my attention was the Sasha Romero here. So they've got these in a few different sizes. Today I've got the 25.5, so I've always been mostly a 5G kind of player. I will occasionally play something like a 4, but 5 is really home for me. And so when we talk about it and say, oh, we've got a Romero style in 25.5, I was really, really intrigued by that. So what is going on with the Romero here? So this is obviously a 25.5 millimeter width on the cup width here. It has a 280 throat, and we did the T1 backbore here, so a little bit tighter backbore, but still really free blowing, which we'll talk about in a second here. I really comfortable rim. It's interesting, over the past few years I feel like I've been seeing more and more of a shift, and to a certain extent, with mouthpiece rims, especially getting a little bit flatter. For a long time, I think a lot of players were really preferring the little bit more of the semi-rounded rim, box style with variations in there. But I'm starting to see a little bit more where players are starting to like a little bit flatter rim. We've seen some of this on the SE Shires artist models with their picket mouthpieces, and a few others as well. And I think this very much falls in line with that. So it's a very comfortable rim to me. Sometimes the flat rims can feel a little bit compact. There's a little bit different bite to them. To me, this still felt really, really comfortable. And I think the extra width kind of helps a little bit as well, but there's still a little bit of curvature to it. Not quite as much as like the Dennis Wick Heritage, which are very, very flat and wide. The experience with this, I really, really enjoyed it. I played with it a few other times, and just like everybody else, I tend one day to the next, I'm not always playing the same. When I came to it today, immediately I felt like it really opened up, very, very nicely. It had a real depth to the sound. There was a stability to the sound that I thought was really, really great. I think that came through like on the Mahler. And even the Brahms, where it felt like I had really great control color in the upper register, but at the same time, there was real flexibility to it. As I was going through the Telemann, excerpts that I was playing, it was still flexible. I felt like I had control. And, honestly, at first, I was really liking what my 5G was doing as far as some of the little bit lighter playing, a little more flexibility. But as I started to dig in and really compare the two, the Romero still had a lot of that flexibility and a little bit more consistency, a little bit more ability to expect where the notes were going to be, which I thought were really, really fantastic as well. And like I said, obviously visually very, very striking. They do offer these in both their their two-tone set, the gold rim and the silver bottom, or they offer it in all silver as well. And of course, one of the really interesting things about these designs is that we do have the removable and interchangeable shanks. Very interesting concept in and of itself. And I think, Jeff and Long Island Brass have got some really great ideas with this. And I think it's going to continue evolving over time here as well. But so far, very, very impressed. I think these are a wonderful addition to the custom mouthpiece collection that we have out there in the trombone world, and I'm real excited to hear more players' feedback on these and where the development goes from here. So, as always, I really appreciate you watching here. If you have any thoughts, questions about what you heard, please leave them in the comments. We'd love to have you as a part of our community here. If you have any experience with the long island brass, put them in there. If you haven't already done so, please consider subscribing to our channel, hitting that notification button so you find out when we've got more videos come out, hitting that like button on this, and of course, you can always find the Trombone Shop on Facebook and Instagram as well. As always, thank you for watching.